sure to keep clear of the car.
I would like to workshop this idea.
Oh, sure.
The film opens with a brief story on the tale of Cleopatra and Antony. On their wedding day, he presented her with three golden bejeweled eggs as a symbol of his love for her. And after their deaths, the eggs were hidden for centuries and believed to be mere myths. But two of the eggs were later unearthed by a farmer, while the third remained hidden in secrecy. In the present day, someone is working on a replica of one of the eggs. In Rome, a special agent named Hartley joins Interpol Inspector, her name is Urvashi, at a museum on the hunt for a wanted art thief named Nolan. After being given information by a source known only as the bishop, they speak to the museum director as he leads them to one of Cleopatra's eggs on display to the tourists. Hartley does a thermal reading of the egg, and he uses a kid's can of Coke to reveal that the egg on display is a fake and someone else has the real one. As she orders the place to be locked down, Nolan pops out of the crowd and makes a run for it with the egg. The guards chase him, and Hartley was close to catching him, but Nolan tries to escape again and Hartley follow him. Nolan rides off on a motorcycle. As Hartley tries to chase him in a car, he gets T-boned by a gelato truck and Nolan gets away. Days later in Bali, Nolan finds Hartley in the home and brings out the agents to arrest him and secure the egg. Hartley accuses him of stealing William Strang's lady with a red hat, but Nolan says that he can't prove that. As the team takes Nolan away, an unknown agent switches out the egg for a fake one. Hartley goes back to Rome, where he is found in a bar by Urvashi. She shows him the egg, which was replaced after shattering it on the floor. She also notes that an $8 million wire transfer was sent to his bank account, leading her to believe that he was involved in the robbery. Although he insists that he is innocent, she has Hartley arrested. Hartley is sent to a Russian prison, where he finds that Nolan will be his cellmate. Hartley deduces that he was set up by the bishop, and Nolan informs him that whoever is in possession of the three eggs, he must deliver them to an Egyptian billionaire by the eve of his daughter's wedding for a payment of $300 million. And the men know that the second egg is in the possession of an international arms dealer, and a chance to swipe the egg from him would be during one of his famous parties. Moments later, Nolan draws attention to them by yelling out to the whole cafeteria that Hartley is a cop. This prompts a large and dangerous inmate to stand up and challenge Hartley. Although Hartley tells him that he doesn't want trouble, he hits Hartley in front of everyone before guards bring him. After that, they back to their cell. The next day, they have an important visit. The guys are brought to meet the bishop face to face, and she turns out to be the undercover agent who swapped out the eggs. And she says that she transferred money to Hartley's bank account, and also that she has been one step ahead of Nolan to become the world's number one art thief. And she's sure that Nolan knows where the location of the third egg is, and will let him out of there with a 10% cut, but he refuses to tell her anything. She orders the guards to put them in hard labor. While trying to come up with a plan to clear his name, Hartley makes the most of his time having to work with Nolan. In their cell, Hartley asks Nolan about his father, because he knew that Nolan's dad was a police captain. So he wonders how that a police captain's son would go on to become a criminal. Nolan says that his dad was a jerk who cared more about his work than he did his own son. When he believed that Nolan lost a beloved watch of his, the man didn't talk to him for a year, until he discovered it was hidden behind some paperwork. The guys enact their plan when Nolan throws a bar of soap into a cleaning solution and throws it into a machine to create an explosion. In the ensuing chaos, the men fight off the guards before making their way to a chopper. Using a badge, Nolan swiped off a guard when the man attacked Hartley. Nolan makes it onto the chopper, while Hartley runs across the bridge as the guards blow it up. As Hartley tries to climb up the bridge, Nolan fires the chopper's machine guns. He starts flying away until Hartley manages to climb up and jump into the chopper. The guards attempt to fire a missile at them, but Hartley manages to have it fly through the chopper and hit a mountain instead. They then make their getaway. The bishop is keeping an agent captive in his office until she uses his computer to send a decrypted message to Urvashi to inform her that Hartley and Nolan are on the loose, as well as an invitation to Sotto Voce's party. The agent trips an alarm, but the responding agent is knocked out by Bishop. She threatens the first agent to tell a lie about what happened or she will get to his loved ones and reveal his darkest secrets to them. Nolan gets help from a contact, Tambwe, to pick him and Hartley up and take them on a plane to Sotto Voce's place in Valencia. He comes up with a plan to get into Voce's safe, which only opens with his thumbprint and facial recognition software, which Nolan is prepared for with his own tech. The guys show up at the party, which is a masquerade ball, so they can get by undetected. Bishop is there already, so Hartley dances with her, to avoid drawing negative attention. Voce spots them, and decides to cut in out of jealousy. Nolan swipes a glass containing Voce's thumbprint. The two find the safe, but are found by Urvashi, who holds a gun to them, and orders Hartley to arrest Nolan, if he really is on the side of the law. Hartley disarms Urvashi before he and Nolan get inside the safe and lock it. Bishop has somehow already made her way inside, and fights the men for the egg, until Voce comes in. She turns out to be in league with Bishop, and they have Hartley and Nolan knocked out and taken captive. She interrogates Hartley with electric cables, for the whereabouts of the third egg. Voce nearly strangles Hartley, because he thought that they are friends, but Nolan relents and says that the egg is in a pyramid in Cairo. When it looks like Voce and Bishop are about to head off together, he collapses after she spiked his drink, leaving her to get away. Voce comes to moments later but has his vision impaired. He fires at Hartley and Nolan, and they become free from their cuffs. The guys try to escape, but end up in the bullfighting arena outside. Hartley gets knocked around a couple of times, and Voce tries to shoot at them again, but he is knocked out by the bull before the guys flee. The two make it onto a train, where Nolan admits he lied about the third egg's location. Hartley nearly throws him off the train until he relents and pulls him back in. He then tells Nolan about his father, who was a con man that just disappeared from his life when he was 13. Nolan then tells Hartley a little history about the third egg. It was recovered by a Nazi art collector named Rudolf Zeich, and after stashing away all the stolen Nazi artifacts, the egg remained hidden. Nolan later found out that the watch that his father loved so much was actually a key to finding the safe where the egg is kept. The guys go to Argentina, where they find a passageway to a huge vault containing loads of stolen artifacts. After they find the egg, Bishop arrives along with Urvashi and her team of agents. A shootout ensues, which leads to a chase through the caves in old cars. Bishop and Urvashi struggle for the egg during the chase, but Nolan manages to get it back. The three ride their car out of the cave and over a waterfall. Nolan grabs the egg and starts to leave, but he can't find Hartley. Not wanting to let him die, Nolan attempts to go into the water to save him, but he turns out to be fine. Bishop swims to shore, but when it looks like Hartley is about to arrest her, they instead kiss. They then reveal that Hartley was working with Bishop the whole time, as they are a couple who have been planning the egg heist from the beginning, and used Nolan to lead them to the third egg. They leave him cuffed to a tree before making their getaway. Hartley and Bishop go to Cairo, where the billionaire is hosting his daughter's wedding, presenting her not only with the three eggs, but also a special musical performance from Ed Sheeran. Urvashi and her agents crash the party to arrest the billionaire and Ed because he tried to fight guards. While Hartley and Bishop get away quietly, 6 months later, the couple is found on a boat by Nolan. He informs them that he tipped off Urvashi about the couple's scheme, and she has their whole $300 million steal frozen in their accounts. Nolan offers them a chance to team up with him on another bigger score, or he will leave them to be arrested. Hartley and Bishop reluctantly agree. Urvashi and her agents arrive too late and find neither of them. She goes back to her office and issues a red notice on all three criminals. The three then arrive in Paris to the location of their next big score, the Louvre. Thanks for watching, take care, and see you in the next video. Man, I've been fearless, I let them feel this. You know, I spit it, no cap when I kill this.